Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and in today's video what I wanted to do with you guys is dive into how I use Evernote. Now I haven't done a video like this for a long time, maybe roughly around the 2 year mark or 3 year mark, so this will be a sort of recap of how I'm currently using Evernote. Now, if you haven't seen the previous video that we created about Evernote being the best filing cabinet, definitely recommend checking it out because it gives you a bit of an idea of why I believe it's the best filing cabinet and not necessarily my note-taking tool anymore. So I'll include that video in the description below. So in today's video, guys, I will be covering 3 use cases and examples of using Evernote across a day. These are very specific and also they will sort of outline the majority of my use of the application these days. And then at the end, I'll wrap up by talking through some of the principles that I implement, like the para method, and also doing a little bit of a cleanup to showcase an active, normal working Evernote account. So let's start with number one. The first way that I use Evernote is primarily for uploading receipts, but I need to be able to save my receipts as I come back from a trip. I've maybe been on 6 or 7 major trips this year for work, and being able to keep a track of those receipts is really important for not just me, but the accountant and records. So being able to keep a track of them is really important. So the way that I do that currently is I primarily have physical receipts and online receipts. And what I'll do is at the end of the month, I will open my middle drawer, which has all of the receipts in them, and I will take them out and individually scan them using the Evernote camera. I'll then scan them into the desktop version. So I'll load up the desktop version on my computer. Then what I'll do is I'll be able to go in and convert that note or those notes into PDFs. Now this is a really useful thing to do because the way that I like to upload stuff to my receipt bank, which I'll explain in a moment, is in PDF format. So going over, right-clicking on an image and converting that image to a PDF or the entire note to a PDF can save you a lot of time. So what I'll do is I'll have PDF versions of them. I'll then go over to Receipt Bank, which is the uploader for my receipts that connects with the accounting software I use, Xero, and I will upload them there. I don't just do this with physical receipts. I will also do this with online receipts as well. So services or SaaS services that I may have used, I'll upload them to Evernote and I'll have this sort of backlog of all of the receipts. This is also important in my personal life as well. Like I have a lot of receipts for example, could be some new running shoes that I got or some boxing gloves that I picked up. And I want to be able to save them inside of somewhere where I can easily access them. And I tend to upload them via the Evernote desktop version. I tend to download the email through Missive and then save it to Evernote. Of course, the feature I'm missing there is the forward Evernote emails, which is a bit of a pain, but something that I'm not really using the bandwidth, so I guess I don't necessarily need to upgrade for it. Okay, so that was the first use, and the first use is primarily uploading stuff and making sure that I'm always keeping track of receipts and things like that. Just to touch on that, obviously I'm uploading a fair few bits, but you get 60 megabytes a month in the free plan, and I tend not to hit that. I think I get in the range of like 35 to 40, maximum per month. So at the moment, that's really suitable for me. Okay, so the second use case is general documents. Now, as I go about my day, naturally, I want to be able to have a little bit of like a filing cabinet nearby, and that is Evernote for me. Being able to go into the application, go into a specific notebook and find relevant information, whether it's like my national insurance number or whether it is like some documents for an electoral roll. For example, the other day I got confirmation that I was on register to vote, so I would save that document straight away inside of Evernote so that I definitely and made sure that I have that PDF available if I'm on the go and I am asked that by a bank or something like that, and they need that bit of information. Whether they're useful documents around setting up banking has been incredibly helpful to be able to access that information at any given time. and having the mobile application has saved a lot of time. And I've not necessarily even had to use the offline notebooks as well, because I'm always tend to be near enough a 4G connection. So this sort of does touch on past use of this as well. I utilize something called the Para method, which is developed by a chap called Tiago Forte. If you haven't watched the Tiago Forte series here on this channel, I think you'll benefit from it. 4 videos, you'll really love it. But his methodology, Para, covers projects, areas, responsibilities or resources, and archives. And that's how I organize my notebooks. But I'll touch on that nearer the end of this video. So the reason I mention that is because a lot of the old folders or files that I have are inside of archives, which will allow me, for example, if I'm in a bank meeting and I need to know previous addresses or previous documents that a landlord gave me from previous tenancies, I might be able to access that through the archives area and not really be in any bad situations in being able to find that information when I need it at the time. Okay, so my third and final use is a very, very small use, and it's very similar to the being able to track your documents. Is anytime I get a reference number or reference document, I tend to save it inside of Evernote. So you're probably wondering, what's a reference number? So for example, if I'm signing up to a direct debit, or I'm in the UK, you're signing up to like a way that the bank takes money, then I will log that number down. For example, if I'm in a customer service or support queue and they give me a reference number for next time I need to quote, then I'll take that one down. And this is really useful. I pretty much store any number that isn't my passwords or very important numbers inside of Evernote, which gives me the ability to quickly access something at any given time. So for example, come back from the post office, I'll take the tracking number down or take a photo of it. For example, the other day when I was just checking our gas and electric meter readings, what I did is I took a photo of the actual meter reading. Then what I did is uploaded it as a photo and marked it down, so that when I need that, when people say, when did you take the meter reading and what was the meter reading, I've got all that information quickly accessible there. So let's just summarize. Firstly, I use it for receipts. Secondly, I use it for general documentation. And third, for tracking numbers and useful details like that. Now, I think one of the biggest questions a lot of people have is, why don't you use Notion for uploading files and information like that? And that's actually a really relevant question, because Notion does have an ability to upload filing to it. And of course, you can upload as many files. There's no limitations on that as well, if you're on the personal plan. But even on the free plan, you're allowed unlimited files as long as the file is no larger than 5 megabytes. So the reason for me that I don't use Notion as a way to upload files, apart from maybe the occasional one if I'm planning a trip, the reason why I don't use it is mainly because of the way that they upload it. They upload it to a web server, which is good and really easy, but in Evernote you're locally storing it, and that's quite good because I can find that when I'm offline. Notion's abilities offline aren't fantastic at the moment, although they are working on it. And I do like to have all of my files, I guess, in one place. So for example, if I'm going into Evernote, I know where everything is because it's in one notebook. Whereas if I started a process now inside of Notion, I'd have to make sure I created some sort of development so that whenever time I go in, I am able to find it. And things like search aren't really fantastic inside of Notion as well. That's something that definitely Evernote allows you to do, be able to search documents and files, which saves a huge amount of time. Okay, so I'm gonna wrap up with talking about the Para method, which is something developed by Tiago Forte, and then also talk to you through how I'm gonna clean up my Evernote account. And I'll do a little bit of it while we're on this video. So the Para method is something that Tiago Forte developed in, actually it's embedded in a course called The Second Brain. You could check that out in the description below. What I like about the Para method is it's organized in a very structured fashion. I've actually used this for both my Google Drive, although that definitely needs cleaning up, and my Evernote for many years now, maybe since 2012. Now, the methodology is very simple. You've got one, projects. This stack in my Evernote essentially includes projects that are active in the last 1 to 12 months and that will last that length in period. And then your areas, which is number 2, this is a stack again, and also includes anything from 1 to 3 years. So as you can imagine, it's gonna include longer, more consistent stuff. then I can quickly access. Then I've got resources, which is the majority of my things like electoral health information that I can quickly access, documents that maybe my GP have sent over. And then, for example, the archives. Now, archives is where projects and areas come to die. So I've got like anything back there, which is very handy, from previous tenancies to Cub Scout leadership information and what we did on certain activities, registers, things like that, from the good old days when I was doing that. But as you can imagine, it's a really easy way to set things up if you're struggling with an Evernote setup. Now, moving on to a little bit of cleanup. Now, you may see from my account that it's definitely a little bit messy. I haven't really updated my parameter method for a while. Although I have been utilizing the tool, I haven't really been keeping updated with it. So I'm just gonna briefly clear up here. But as you can imagine, your Evernote can get like this, like if you don't have routine cleanup. So I'm gonna dedicate maybe like an hour every 2-3 months to actually just clean up my Evernote account and make sure that every project that's in the projects area is relevant, every project area that's in the areas is relevant, etc. And I'm making use best of titles as well. So guys, that was an overview of how I use Evernote. Now, I hope hopefully it was really useful. If you guys are interested, I will be doing an Evernote versus Notion video very soon, although I do need to still plan this one. And if you have any questions, feel free to pop them in the comments below. I'm sure people were curious about the way that I'm using it, at least. And I'm really curious about how you're using it. So please do tell me in the comments below whether you have a similar experience or you've been doing something a little bit different from me. Anyway, guys, a big thank you. If you're not subscribed here yet, you need to be subscribed. It'll be great to have you. We've got some exciting updates coming up and I'm sure you'll thoroughly enjoy it. Anyway, guys, I'll talk to you soon and thank you very much for stopping by today. Cheers, everyone.